While combing the shortwave for truth, Paul Gordon Collier stumbled upon one man, Rico, who warned of an impending zombie apocalypse. Rico pledged that he would not only survive the zombie apocalypse, he would conquer the zombies, and he would show us how to as well. So Paul began sharing Rico's reports on Rico.com. That's FREEQO.com. Now we bring you the Rico Report. In this Rico Report, we bring you a unique take on the latest effort to stop another religious liberty bill designed to stop Christian businesses from being destroyed by the quote-unquote homo-fascist extremist, unquote. Here is the man himself, Rico.
This story is from the Columbia, Missouri. It's about a group of Gestapo activists that want to make sure if they tell you to bake a cake for their gay wedding, you bake a freaking cake for their gay wedding. Here's the gist of it from the article. Nearly 100 members of the Missouri LGBT advocacy group, Promo, and others delivered petitions against the legislation to leaders in the GOP-controlled House, where the proposed constitutional amendments awaits a committee hearing. The proposed ballot measure would amend the Missouri Constitution to prohibit government penalties for photographers, florists, and other professionals who cite religious beliefs while declining to provide wedding-related services of quote-unquote expressional or artistic creation to same-sex couples. It also would apply to clergy and religious institutions. The measure passed the Senate on March 10 following a failed 37-hour filibuster by the Democrats, who argued it will permit discrimination against LGBT people. In the article, it says, some of the rallying carried signs that read, "Bake my cake!" in rainbow writing, and "Free Missouri from discrimination!" Yeah. Yeah. What they really want to do is force you, by government gun, to provide a service to them that they want you to provide, even if you don't want to provide it. You can judge whether someone is a tool or not a tool for baking a cake for a gay wedding. But if you support Daddy Gov socking that business with hundreds of thousands of dollars worth of fines, then you're an even bigger tool than the people you might think are tools. You see, this militant homosexual activism, it's well-funded, and it's supported by the zombie generals, who see it as an opportunity to set yet another freedom-taking, anti-zombie power-destroying precedent, allowing the government to pick and choose which people you have to provide services to. To be sure, the root of this precedent was set with the Anti-Liberty, Pro-Zombie Civil Rights Act that identified a government-created problem, state-instituted racism and oppression, and fixed it, and I put that in quotes, fixed it by empowering the government to violate your alleged First Amendment rights, the freedom of assembly, or the right to free association. Yes, true liberty means letting people be tools. No, not being able to get a wedding cake from someone who doesn't like you for whatever reason they choose, or doesn't like what you're going to do with their product or services for whatever they choose, is not a violation of your liberty. It's their product, their service, their stuff, not yours, not Daddy Gus. Now, if you think the folks who wrote this bill and voted for it are part of the pro-liberty, anti-zombie crowd, guess again, my friends. You see, they're not arguing against the state's right to deny you your natural given right to free association. No, no, no. They're simply arguing that your right to religious liberty trumps their quote-unquote right to force the government to make you their indentured servant and bake them that freaking cake. This whole op is nothing but a little jiu-jitsu applied by the pro-zombie generals, who represent both the authors of the bill and the Democrats who tried to filibuster the bill. What's really going on here is that, through this action, which makes one camp of slaves feel like someone is trying to help them with their freedoms, they are cementing the authority. Now put that in quotes. The presuppositional authority that the state has the power, the right, to decide who you do work for and who you do not work for. The state can decide who you open your doors to and who you close your doors to. Believe me, Freako, when I tell you that the day is coming soon when the state will push for laws that will prevent you from associating with individuals that are deemed as being undesirables. They'll start off with a condition such as putting you on a terror watch list, which will then justify them preventing you from associating with people who might be considered either on that list already or at risk of going on that list. The real target here, friends, is the zombie killers. That's us, the Army of Liberty. But we will not be silenced. We will not be forced to disassociate ourselves from one another. We will rise, for when the zombies come, we won't just survive. We will be victorious.
It doesn't.